Hello, I'm Elizabeth Hall with Smart Office Help, Social Media Management, and today I'm going to show you how to add a Twitter widget to your WordPress site. Before we get started, I just wanted to say, if you like to get updates on future videos that are posted, you can subscribe below and also to rate this video. Okay, let's get started. All right, why would you want to add a Twitter list or a box to your website? Because when people come to your website, you'll give them another option to follow you on your social media. Now, if you look here, this is actually Smart Office Help's website, and this is a widget area over here, and this is the Twitter box here. So if you look, you can actually see the most recent post here. You can actually hit the follow button, so this is a way for you to pick up some followers as well, or you can send a tweet to Smart Office Help by clicking here. So first thing is your WordPress site needs to be widgetized. So that means that you need to be able to put widgets on your site. There are some themes that are not widgetized, so you just want to make sure that your WordPress theme does allow widgets. Okay, let's go over to Twitter, and you're going to go to your settings. So you'll hit this little wheel here, and then go down to your settings. Here in the screen, you'll go to widgets. All right, now that we're in widgets, you'll see over here on the right, I already have one widget created. So we're going to create a new one. So you'll go to create new. Now, there are actually four types of widgets that you can create here. One is the user timeline, and then you have your favorites, list, and search. So we'll look at the user timeline first. And of course, it's just as it says, it's going to show your timeline. So it'll show your most recent tweets, and it will change, so it's real time. So in the configuration, this allows you to customize how your widget will look on your website. And it also makes it so that you can create it so it'll fit on your website. So first you'll put in your username, and normally it'll automatically populate that field. Then you have your options. You can exclude replies if you like, or you can keep them in. You can change the height of your widget if you like. And then for the theme, it's on light now, and then you can make it dark. You can also change the link color. So you'll just select the link and you'll say done, and then you say create the widget. All right, and then there we go. Once it creates the widget, you'll see where the link changed there. So, and it says your widget has been created. But before we add this one in, well, we'll go ahead. We have the embedded code here at the bottom. So you'll just select that and copy it. And then once you copy that code, you go into your WordPress site, into the admin area. Now, if you don't know how to get to your widgets, it's pretty easy. You're going to go here where you have your menu here on the side. You go to Appearances, Widgets, and then you'll have to create a text box if you don't already have one available. So if you look here, these are all your available options for your widgets. You're going to select text, and then you'll drag it over to the widget area that you want. Now, we already have one chosen, so I have it open here, and you embed your code in. You don't have to put anything in for the title. Just put your embedded code in and say save. And then once you save it, if you look back at your website, it'll save pretty quickly. You'll see your Twitter widget on your website. Okay, let's go back over to Twitter for a moment. And because I want to show you a couple of more settings. So we'll go to widgets again, and we'll say create new again. All right, so let's look at the other types of widgets that you can have here. If you go to favorites, you'll see in favorites, it's basically the same configuration. You put in your username and you'll pick an option whether you want to auto expand your photos. Now, why would you want to auto expand your photos? Maybe you have a website that is visually based, like maybe you're an artist and you want to show off some artwork that you saw at an art show. Maybe you went to a museum, so some inspirational photos. So you want to have those show up, so you'll put in auto expand. And again, you can change the height, you can change the theme color from light to dark, and you can change your link colors as well. And if you go over to list, now with the list, you would have to have already had your list created. Now, if you don't know how to create Twitter lists, I actually have a video, and you can go to that on how to create and use Twitter lists. So I do have some lists here that are all set up, so I'll just go down and I can select one of the lists here. I just pick podcast list. And then again, most of the options are basically the same. You can pick the theme, dark or light. You can pick the height that you want and you can change the link colors. And then the last option that they have here is the search. Now in the search, you would use a hashtag to search. So let's put in one. We'll put in hashtag social media. Okay, and you'll see, and this is in real time, it's showing any posting or tweets that have the hashtag social media in them. And this is what will show up on your website once you embed the code. So you would just pick your other options again, and then you would say create widget. Now I'm going to show you one more little thing here. Now, just so your widgets don't get all cluttered up and you get confused, you can actually delete them when you don't need them anymore. So the second one here, I don't need, so I'm gonna go ahead and delete it. And you just simply say delete. It'll ask you if you're sure, and you hit delete again, and that's it. So now you have a nice widget and you have configured it the way that you want it. I have the colors that I want for mine, and it's just perfect for people to be able to follow you from your website. So if you have any other social media related questions, please leave those in the comments and it may be answered on a future video or a future podcast. Anywhere around, I will answer those questions for you. So go out and grow your networks using social media. Have a great day.